Hey, I'm Matt Fryer Golf and welcome to the Cala Resort. I'm going to take you through the three golf courses here and see what they have to offer and what playing golf at the Cala entails. Sit back, enjoy, and hopefully these tips can help you get the best golf when you come to the Cala. So when you come down to play golf at the Cala, every single round that you start, you're going to come here to the clubhouse. You're going to get your buggies, your trolleys, check in for a round of golf, whichever course you're playing here. You're able to get your water, anything that you need from the pro shop. And also, it's the hub of all activity. You may want to drink before, you may want to grab a light bite before you go out, and you can do that all here in the clubhouse, and even when you've finished. If you had a good round, maybe you've earned yourself a drink or two. I'm gonna head in and check out, and then we'll get out onto the golf course. So one of the three courses here is the Campo Asia course, also known as the South course before they were all rebranded. Now the Asia course is actually the shortest golf course here, but don't let that fool you. Just because it's short doesn't mean it's difficult. It requires a lot of strategic shots off the tee because of its undulation and winding golf holes, especially holes like the 10th, where you've got to get those clubs right because you are playing up to greens. You might be playing down to greens or going around corners. So you've got to make sure you respect the golf course here and make your club selection the correct one when you're playing out on Asia. Let's go and take a look at a few of the holes and see what they're like. We're on the signature 10th hole here at the Campo Asia with Hotel La Cala in the background and also the clubhouse in the background. What we've got to do here though when we play this hole is make sure we get our strategy right, because anything that doesn't cover enough ground on the left-hand side is going to fall away down the hills into the shrubbery and you're not going to find your golf ball. You've got to allow and understand how far you're going to hit it, play out to the right-hand side and let the slopes feed it back. Then the second test comes in. Do you go for it on this par 5 green in 2, or do you lay up and get the right yardage on that one? Let's see if we can successfully navigate this hole with a little par. So I'm going to play a little bit down the right with my fade and allow the slope to do the work for me. Nicely down there. And it's just bouncing just back towards centre. Let's see if we can complete the task. So I've found the fairway here. Now the temptation would come in. I've got 240 yards up towards the flag, but if we have a look up this hole here, what we'll notice is that it's severely uphill. So if I were to go for this and I did end up getting it up on the fairway or up near the green, the chances are it's probably going to come rolling back down to me. And also, if I were to just lay up willy-nilly here, I'm playing into a slope and I'm playing into uneven ground. There actually is a spot about 140 yards down for myself here that's going to be flat ground and give me a good stance and then allow me to navigate the next upslope with a better chance. So what I'm going to do here, normally on a par 5, if I had that distance, I would just go for it. But now I'm going to be able to hit a 9-iron for myself, knowing I can hit it 145, and even if it rolls down a little bit, it's still going to come back to that flat. But what I'm doing is setting up my next shot and allowing that shot into the green to be a lot easier, because it would be easy just to hit one down willy-nilly and not understand the severity of the slopes here on the 10th hole. So nicely down, and I've caught my flat spot, and that should leave me with a pretty nice shot into the next hole. So we've got to my ball now, and I've found myself just here on a slightly flatter spot than what we would find further up the hole. And also, one of the things here, as you go further up towards the green, it starts to narrow up, so strategic play here on the Asia course is a must. Don't just come out here and hit it willy-nilly. Make sure you understand where you're hitting your golf ball to and how the slopes are going to affect it. Now I've left myself 109 yards to the flag, but it's actually playing 125 up the hill. So normally 109 is going to be my 54, but I'm going to take a pitching wedge to equate for this slope, get it all the way back up there and hopefully set up a birdie opportunity. And it's a pretty nice strike and it looked like it was heading towards the flag. And that's one other thing you've got to learn to do when you come and play golf at La Cala. On that shot then, I actually couldn't see the pin because of the severity of the slope. So what you've got to do is pick a sight line, maybe a tree behind the green, focus on that and make a committed swing towards your sight line. Don't be second guessing where that place is. Pick your spot and then trust it. Let's go and see if we can finish this hole off. So as we get up onto the green here now, we find my golf ball, and I did my job. I got it beyond the flag. As we just pan back down there, we can see that I've gone beyond it. The other thing that we can see is the clubhouse and also the hotel just sitting there, and what a view it is up here from this 10th hole on the Asia golf course. But like I said a second ago, when you are out here on the golf courses, do make sure you understand the severity of the slopes and playing into the greens, because we've got to see that we're hitting it beyond the flags on most of the golf courses out here. Because if you fall short, the ball will end up rolling back down a hill, and sometimes it can even roll back past you depending on the severity of that slope. So don't be afraid to go beyond them, because there is a little bit of a back cushion beyond it. And also, we've got to equate in our strike sometimes. If we don't quite catch it, we don't want to look a fool. But now I'm up on the green. Let's see if I can tickle this one down to the hole and get out of here with my par that I used my strategy for and constructed in a good manner. Just gonna trace down that hill now. Go on then, go on. Oh, not bad, a little tap in. Let's go and head over to one of the other golf courses and find out a little bit about those. The great thing about all the courses here at La Cala Golf Resort is that they're a quick drive away from the clubhouse. So once you've got your buggy, hop on, and you're at the first tee of any of the three golf courses within just 2 minutes. So very simple to access to everything, nice and easily signposted, easy to get around. And the good thing is you can see all the courses as well from the clubhouse as you start. So we find ourselves at Campo America. This was formerly known as the North Golf Course before the renaming of them. And what we find here on Campo America is much wider fairways and less bunkers. But don't be fooled to think that that's going to make it the easiest of the driving courses, because what we find is quite hilly topography out here on the golf course. So what we've got to do is make sure that we're aware of the undulations out on the golf course. And also, one of the features of Campo America is small raised greens. So club selection into the greens is critical. You'll probably find it on the fairway more often, but then getting the right club to hit it onto the green is a must. So make sure you take your time to understand what club you're going in with. And as you walk onto the first tee here as well, I would say that this is probably one of my favorite first tee views in golf. We look out towards the Mediterranean Sea. We've got the Andalusian hills here. You know what, it's a joy to tee off. We've got big wide open fairways, but like I said a moment ago, we've got to understand how undulation is going to play a part here, because it plays a part here and it also plays a part on the Europa golf course. Here on the first tee, as we just have a look out here, we actually have the first hole, the second hole and the third hole facing us. What we don't want to do is try and be too cute here on the first tee of the America golf course. What we can do is actually go over onto the second fairway if we want to give ourselves a little bit more leeway. Don't try biting the corner off too much, but if you are a long hitter, you potentially could do that. You could get a little bit further up there and get further up towards this green on this opening par five. But do bear in mind, you've got a wider room out towards the left-hand side. So myself here, I'm going to play a little left and see, even if I get my little fade working, I can get somewhere on a fairway. That would be nice. And you know what? I'll take that as a first tee shot. It's not done too bad there. Let's get down into the rest of the hole and talk you through how playing this opening hole is going to help you get off to a flyer. One thing that's going to help your rounds get better and better each time you play at La Cala is knowing your distances, and also knowing where the slopes are around the green. For instance, on this first hole at the America course, I've now got 119 yards to the flag. an easy little wedge for myself, but if I was a little bit greedy and just pushed it slightly right, what happens with a lot of the greens, they have big runoff areas that will take you down to bunkers, off into ravines, and can make what wasn't the worst shot in the world probably get a little bit of bad luck. So for me here, when you're playing, always make sure you've either studied the course card, whether you've got a GPS or something along those lines. It's just going to help you get a little bit more information around the greens, because here on the left hand side of the green there's a lot of undulation working the ball back towards the center of the green. So for myself now, knowing that pin's a little bit on the right hand side, I can take the correct club. I've factored in the fact that it's actually a little bit uphill as well, and also taking the wind into account, but also I'm going to factor in where is the best spot to miss it. Don't just walk up to your ball and hit it. Have a look at the surroundings. Where are the bunkers? Where are the undulations? And from there then you could play to each safe zone around the golf course, and what might be not your best shot might actually get fed quite close towards the flag. So let's give this one a little hit. I'm going to play about 5 yards left of the flag and let the slopes bring it in. Little bit skinny, but you know what? It's nice and safe up on the green, and I've not ended up running into trouble. Let's go and give it a putt. This was the perfect example of what I was talking about down on the fairway. I thought that flag had about 5 or 6 yards minimum away from the edge of the green, but as we can see there, it's about 3 paces from being in severe trouble. But because I played towards a safer zone, I've ended up a little bit past because it was a bit thin, but now I've got an easier putt, or an easier chance for myself of making a birdie with 2 putts here, instead of trying to take any flag on that's right near a slope and just missing it and ending up in a world of trouble. Oh, and I thought we were going to get it in one there. Let's head over to a few different spots on the golf course and see what Campo America's all about. So I'm here on the 5th hole, and this is the prime example of how the topography, the hills, are going to affect your approach play. Because if we just have a look up here to where the flag is now, we see it just poking up between 2 trees there, and it's 145 yards. Now, if I were to just go and grab my normal 145 yard club, I'm going to come up short. And what I suggest, any hole, any course you're playing at La Cala, when you see the number for the front of the green, try and play to the middle or to the back, because a lot of them you'll be going up to the hill, and a lot of people will fall short of greens here, maybe due to misstrike, maybe due to misconception of how far you're hitting it. But one of the main things that we do is misunderstand how much these slopes are actually going to play a part here. So for me, normally a 145 is a nice 9 iron. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to take my 8 iron, which is my 165 club. Looking at where that flag is, knowing the golf course, I think that's sort of middle to backish. So I'm now going to play this shot as if it's going to be playing 160 yards. And my 8 iron is my 165 club. So what I'm going to do here now is just accept that it's not 145. I'm going to say in my mind it's a 160 shot. So now I can pull this 8 iron out, give it a confident swing, and not think that I'm going to be going miles and miles past the flag because of how much I'm going up the hill. So let's give this one a go. I know how far this is going to go. Good swing and commit to it. And there, nicely high up in the air because of the launch pad of the hill. And it looks like it's dropped just a little bit past pin high. But you know what, saying that, when we get up there, I'll probably be surprised and it might be a little bit short. But let's head up and see how that slope has really affected that golf shot. So we're just getting up towards the green now. And as we can see, like I said earlier, very small, narrow surface. But on this time, I've managed to convince myself it wasn't that 145. I've actually pitched that, as we can see in here, and always remember, do prepare your pitch marks. I've actually pitched it only a yard past the flag there, and it's pulled up maybe 15 feet beyond. So what was normally a 9 iron for me, I've hit a great 8 iron, and I've only just gone by the flag. Imagine if I hadn't struck that well, I'll be down at the front of the green there. So whenever you're playing any of the golf holes here at La Cala, try, if you can, to remember the slopes and maybe think about playing uphill, downhill, and also remember to give your putts a little bit of a hit. Let's go and take a look at another course here at La Cala. Campo Europa is one of the other courses here at the La Cala Golf Resort, and I would say it's probably the friendlier golf course out of them, with wider fairways, less undulation and larger greens. It just makes it that little bit easier, and probably for your average golfer, I always think it's a great way to start your holiday here at La Cala with a round on the Europa, just to ease yourself in and get used to what you're about to face on the other golf courses. Let's head out on the golf course and take a look at a few of the holes here that make it such a beautiful golf course. So one of my favourite holes here on Campo Europa is the 18th hole. It's 366 metres, and for those long hitters, it gives us an opportunity to potentially drive the green. Even for the average golfer, it gives you a chance of hitting your longest drive because it's all the way straight downhill. One of the other beautiful things about it is the view. You're pretty much at the highest point of the golf course up here, and you're able to see views out towards the Mediterranean. We can see the Andalusian hills all the way around, and we can see a lot more of the golf course. It is truly a spectacular tee to stand on and finish a great round, or hopefully you've had a great round. I'm going to give this a rip and see if I can get anywhere near hitting this green down at the bottom of this hill. But do beware when you're on here as well. Slightly offline and you might not be finding your golf ball, so take it with a little bit of caution. Okay, and it's a nice hit. Drifting a little bit to the right. Okay, bouncing, 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 still bouncing. And you know what? It's pretty much near the greenside trap on the right. Let's head down there and see where that one is finished. So just driving down towards the green. We've actually got speed bumps on the cart there because of how downhill this actually is. But should give you an idea, just looking back out of the cart here, how undulating it is. And if we just now pull the buggy up here, let's get over this speed bump. We stop here and just have a little wander with me. We can see how far this one's actually gone. You can look back up there as well, all the way from the top there. And I was quite lucky there. I didn't pick a line where I should have gone tighter to the left, because we can see where my ball has actually ended up there. If it would have been any slightly right, it would have gone down into the water hazard there. So when you've got those undulations, just understand how much distance it's going to add or take off, and then you can add that into the equation. If you just play them as your normal shots, you'll find that you're starting to get into a lot of trouble as you're playing those. I'm going to go and give this a little chip and see if I can get a cheeky little birdie. It's not bad. I've got about a 3 or 4 footer to see if I can finish off in style. Do you know what? I'll take that one. Little three on Europa course here at La Cala. I hope you've enjoyed that little guide to golf at La Cala and given you a few little tips to help you play your best golf when you come here to La Cala. Don't forget as well, we've also got the Golf Academy here that features a driving range, putting green, chipping area, and also a par three little golf course, which is a great fun little test of golf when you're out there. So make sure you've watched those tips and you're going to use them when you're out here to make sure you're playing your best golf when you come and visit next time at La Cala.